I'm terrible at this level. I'll play it and I'll show you what's what. Okay, so you get fully kitted out. Main problem is constantly spewing out enemies. Get on the move again. Now I'm just gonna save there. Looks like I'm doing better than I thought I would. I'll just cheese it so you guys can see what's going on. Not like that. Or like that. Oh. that. That was the cheesed version of the Icon of Sin. If you've played original vanilla Doom, you'll see that the Brutal Doom version's a far upgraded fight. Kind of looks cooler, it's got different attacks. And you can actually attack him without necessarily hitting him straight in the brain. Okay. The horrendous visage of the biggest demon you've ever seen crumbles before you after you pump your rockets into his exposed brain. The monster shrivels up and dies, its thrashing limbs devastating untold miles of hell's surface. You've done it. The invasion is over. Earth is saved. Hell is a wreck. You wonder where bad folks will go when they die now. Wiping the sweat from your forehead, you begin the long trek back home. Rebuilding Earth ought to be a lot more fun than ruining it was.
Okay.
Cool, there you go. Just shows you all the enemies. And their deaths. Shotgun guy. Heavy weapon dude. It's a dude, apparently. Demon. Soul. Keiko. Ignite. New Baron. Rackatron. Pain Elemental. Get out of here. Evil, evil Revenant. Beautiful Incubus. Arc Vile. Vile's the right word. Spider Mastermind. Star Demon. Now that's just the vanilla Doom deaths. Our hero. Should say Doom Guy. But never mind. There we go. That's it, guys. The conclusion of Brutal Doom 2 playthrough. Thank you very much for watching.